be talking about the things that we need. Let me get comfortable. The things that we need in our greenhouse to help our food grow. Okay, so if you want to follow this channel is about growing food only indoors. Okay, never taking it outside to grow. Only indoors in your greenhouse. As you can see, first thing you need is a greenhouse. We need a greenhouse, of course, to grow anything, all right, indoors, okay? And that's to confine everything in one space, all right? The next thing you're going to need is this paper called emergency blanket. Hopefully you guys can see it. And it's called Mylar. If you look on eBay or Amazon, you probably see emergency blanket. Also, you'll see another word called Mylar sheets. They're the same thing. That's what you want to do to bounce the lights off, okay? That's where our source of light is going to come from. It's bouncing off this sheet. And my food has been growing, and I've been loving it, as you guys can see in my garden, all right? Indoor garden, all right? Next thing you're going to need, is some lights, of course. You need lights for your things to grow indoors, okay? Now, I've been doing this for quite a while, so I know that you do not need these lights so close to your seedlings or anything else to grow. They're going to grow regardless, okay? And not be stretchy or anything. So here you go, like this right here. This is not stretchy. It's beautiful. It looks good. This is how you want your plants to look, okay? So the best lights that I prefer to use, I've used different ones, but the best ones I prefer are LED lights, full spectrum, all right? So make sure they're full spectrum and they're LEDs. Full spectrum means they have the full range of every color that the sun has, okay? And make sure they are LED. Now, I got these from Home Depot, and I got these for $39.95 or $39.99. Now, these are only 19 watts each. All right, so that is good. It won't run up your electric bill. I do have four in my greenhouse. At four, I have one in the front, one in the back, and two going this way. All right, guys? And it won't run your electric bill. It's only 19 watts, all right, each. So 76 watts is not bad at all, okay? And with these lights, you can connect them on each end, which I like. So I have some connected, and then I have two of my fans connected to the other one, other outlets that were open, all right, that weren't used. So you get a click here so you can baby. You won't be able to like dim them or anything. That's okay because these are really, really good lights. You don't have to do that. It doesn't put off so much heat that, you know, it's going to burn your plants, and it doesn't. It puts off the right amount. That's why these are full spectrum. Go get them Home Depot, right? The next thing you're going to need is some type of ventilation. So I have two fans hooked up on my ceiling inside here. Excuse me. So this is one that I had. These, I love these. These have two speeds, okay? So you can put them on either speed you like, and they're really good, and you can clip them on, all right? They also have a base to go to these, but I took the base off so I can hang them, and these were only $14.99 at Home Depot, $14.99 at Home Depot, and you can do a lot with them. And you can also swivel the bottom, all right? $14.99 is not bad. I have two, and they were perfectly fine, okay? You need this air to flow through so your plants can move a little, circulate a little, get some circulation in there, okay? So that's what I have that for. And also on your floor, you want to put some type of mats or plastic. I prefer mats more than plastic only because plastic, if it gets too hot, it's going to start holding water. All right, so I prefer these mats, and then they have this rubber on the back will protect your floors. All right, so you can get these mats from anywhere, I guess, but we get these from like the Dollar Tree, which is the cheapest. Okay, so I have 1, 2, 3, 5, maybe 6 of these in here. Like this goes on the outside. I'm gonna put this one outside, but I think I have about 4 or 5 in here, 5 inside, and this one's gonna go on the outside. So that's what I have. All right, so those are basically the things that you're going to need. Also, you're going to need a humidifier. So on those really, really dry days when it gets really, really hot in the summertime and it doesn't seem like you can keep enough moisture in your greenhouse, you're going to need a humidifier for that, all right? And you need a dehumidifier also when it gets too moist in here. You want to make sure you absorb that water still. Moisture doesn't linger around when you get that white stuff on all over your soil and things like that. So you want to keep those things in there too. So I do have one of those coming. And yeah. So far, it's been working good for me. Also, like I said, use the Mylar paper. It's wonderful. It bounces the lights on everything. I have nothing lagging, even if it's on the floor. Nothing's lagging because all the lights are bouncing everywhere in here. And that's what I love about this greenhouse. I love this greenhouse, guys. Do you want to learn how to garden in home and you don't have a space to garden outside, or you can't garden outside, even an apartment or whatever? You can go grow food in home. You don't have to buy such of a big one that I have. This is a 4.5 by 4.5 by 6.5. So you don't have to buy such a big one. I do have a smaller one, about 2 by 2, I think that's what it is, by 4. And you can start your seedlings in that. You could probably get some ventilation in there somewhere, like a little fan in there on every shelf. If you use your imagination, baby, to hook that one up also. So I decided to get a big one so I could put more plants in here. I do have some other things coming, so I can't wait for those to come in. So if you guys like to garden like I do, and you want to garden and you can't outside, and you live in an apartment, or you cannot just because even if you live in your own space or whatever, this is the channel for you. Let's get growing.